at the end of these two designs, tell me which one is your favorite. For now, let's jump in on Canva. To start our first design, we're going to open a blank canvas and we're creating these four henna arts from Head Media YouTube channel. So they ask, we're going to press R for rectangle, and they ask that I can use any color. I'm going to use the gradient color because I love it so much. With a square shape, we're going to be creating our H, and we want it to be harmonious, the color. Therefore, we're not going to be creating separate rectangles because this one picks up the whole gradient color. Then you're going to press R again for another rectangle. This time you're going to change this one and make it white, and then you start creating your H with your rectangle. So you're going to add it to the middle of your H and create that beautiful rectangle letter. And you're going to duplicate the white shape, bring it to the bottom of the page. So it depends on how thick you want it to be. Then you're going to duplicate the square shape. What we want now is to create uneven letters or uneven design, so that you have a design that looks something like that. Next, you're going to go back to your shapes again and create the A. So we're going to be using the triangle up, and you make it smaller. You also change the color. You make it a gradient blue, and you drag it and align it with the top of your H, but the bottom of the H, you make it look something like that. Then you do your corners a little bit rounded to create that A. And then you're gonna go to your elements. You're going to look for arts. Once I was looking for arts, I found this art shape. I don't know what kind of art henna arts is, but when I looked at somebody that was dancing like this, I thought, you know, let's use them. And these are shapes that you could also create with elements that are curved lines and a round shape. So something like this could be definitely created. But you're going to change the color of this artsy person and make it white. And then you're going to add it to our A for design. And you have something like that. Then you're going to go back to shapes and you're going to look for the arch down. And you add it to your design. And you align it to the other letters so that it's perfectly aligned. And then you also change the color to gradient. It looks something like that. Then you duplicate the middle one, you change to white so that you create your U. And then you grab that white rectangle and you add it on there so that it is aligned to your H. And you have a design that looks like this. The last bit would be for you to add text, and you add the name of the business or the tagline of your business. So this artsy kind of a font you could use is Arturo. Then you can edit and then also change the color turquoise, and then you write the name of the place. Slide it on there, and there's your first design. I hope you like it. Let me know in the comments if you do like it. The second design that I want to show you, or that I thought would be fun to create, is if you start by creating a stick man. So you're going to have a head and you're going to use a white oblong shape to have a body. So you're creating your stick man. You're gonna add a line, make it slightly bigger, like 6 for arms for the stick man. And you're gonna have another separate one, and then you're gonna have legs. And you can always just reduce the stick man a little bit and make his color gradient as well, because we're going with gradient for the theme of our design. And because we're creating for an arts place, we want to be artsy with this one. So we're going to add a line, and we're going to make our stickman carry this logo of ours as a cool idea. And we're gonna duplicate the line and create a box. Nice and easy. With your design, you're going to press T for text, and you're also going to change this to that Arturo font that we used, and you will type the initials that she gave us, which is UAH. So you're going to have a nice big capital letter U, rotate that, and then move it to the box, align it, make sure that it fits quite nicely, and then go with the theme of our colors. So we're gonna go blue, turquoise, and blue. And we duplicate that, and we go A. Make sure that it's not touching our lines. And the A, we're gonna make turquoise. And then we do the H as a capital letter. And we just go grab the name, and we add it to the design. So first of all, I'm going to reduce the spacing so that it fits between the stickman and the initials, and then we can change that to a blue as well. Our design, we are going to download and remove the white shapes we've added using remove.bg. So you're gonna go share and download, and you can pick any of the two. Let's convert this one, the second one, to a 3D using Photopea. Now we access remove.bg, and then we add our design, and then it'll take away all the white spaces and the background, and you click on download, and then you access www.photopea.com, and you pick a template that you would convert this logo of ours to 3D. So you select template, and then you pick a template, you click on the link to open it up. After it has loaded, you access the layer that says your logo here, and you click on the checkout box. Once it's open, you hide the example from the designer. You go find your own 2D that was downloaded from remove.bg. You add it on, and as we saw in the example, he said we must make it nice and big. So we will absolutely do that and align it, and we press Command S or Control S to change it to Smart Object. And the first tab is where our design is sitting. I think it's so much fun. I love it. Please let me know in the comments below if this is interesting and fun for you too. I had so much fun. Henna Arts, let us know which one of the two is your favorite. My favorite is this one. If you want more ideas, please go to our playlist for Canva shapes. I do have a course as well on Udemy if you want to support the channel. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you with our next video.